I just bumped my head really hard on the door. It's been a very weird day for me because that's what's been happening. I don't know if you can see, if you can notice this bump right here. But hoping that this episode brings me joy and brings the joy that I need for this day, because otherwise I am in a very bad mood right now. Yes, happy Ganesh Chaturthi to everybody. Anywho, back to the episode. Bye. To the sixth episode of Dimples Out starring Ayushi. I am your host Ayushi Amrite, and today we have this sensational lady who is a phenomenal dancer, choreographer, actor and a model. Now you may know her as Huma from D3, or as Dia from D4 Get Up and Dance, or as a finalist in India's Got Talent Season 5, or as my crewmate from the House of Suraj. Please welcome the oh so gorgeous Anushka Chaudhary.
Hi! Hi Anu, thank you so much for coming on my show.
Thank you for calling me. I'm so excited and I'm so happy for your show that you're doing. It's amazing, like I've been following. So I was waiting, just like I told you when you asked me to do the show. I was like, "Mera turn kab aayega?"
Aayega, aayega, aa gaya. Ab hai tumhara turn. Now is your chance to shine. So now, currently you are in Kolkata. You just moved back, right?
Yeah.
So and you were in Mumbai until now. So like, if like, which city for you is better? If you had to pick, like, is it Kolkata or like Mumbai?
It's a very, very tricky question you just asked me, because see, Calcutta is my home, right? Like, it's my family, my friends, everyone's here. I've grown up here. So I'll, like, no matter what, where I shift, this city will always have, you know, a place in my heart. So that's that. And Bombay for me is just like my workplace and, you know, the dream city, and it has its own lifestyle, its own environment, the vibe. And I mean, I can't live without Bombay as well, because, you know, it's like, I feel you live in Bombay, you won't feel like living anywhere else, like living, you know what I mean?
You
get it.
You know, are giving me such a diplomatic answer, like you're playing so safe right now. If you had to pick one city on a show, which one would it be? Like to live, basically. If you had to settle.
To live.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hands down, it's going to be Bombay, hands down. To live.
Ajao. Yeah, I mean, of course, Kolkata would have a special place for you because you have your family there. And I do like Kolkata. Like, all my Mumbaikers are going to hate me for this. But then I love Kolkata ka puchka. Like,
I knew that it's, was coming. Now it's my turn to ask. Okay, but what will you choose? Pani puri or puchka? If I ask you.
Well, pani puri is like my wife and puchka is like my, like the mistress.
Nice. I like your answer. Nice.
Yeah, see. So like, so I know that you were on D3 and you had this I don't know, kind of a villainish role as Huma.
It was a grey character, grey.
Grey, grey character.
It was grey.
So I know that you, on the show, like how you were, you're like almost like the opposite in real life. Is it?
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
How did things change? Like, did things in fact change around you when you, when the show was aired? Like when you as a character were introduced, like did things change around you?
Oh my god, it changed. It changed. And how? Like, because before D3 last, I was known as the finalist of India's Got Talent season yeah. 5, right? So I didn't have many performances in the show. I had like 5-6 performances, but I had this one audition round which went really viral on internet and on TV and everything yeah. because they used to show my promo, you know, that time in the promo shots, they showed my turns, like, oh my God, classical dancer, wow. And then suddenly they show I'm doing all of this to Karan, and then Karan winked at me, and then Malaika was like, oh my God, Karan loves these kind of dances. And
yeah.
So I became famous as that girl in the white dress going to Karan Johar and doing this.
Okay. Yeah.
Obviously, they didn't know my name. But then, like, I remember I was staying in Yari Road with a friend of mine. I was getting down in the lift. And one girl is like, one auntie was looking at me. She's like, "Arey, aap wahi ladki ho na, jo white dress mein se Karan Johar ke paas ja ke aise se kiya." And I'm like, what is this? I swear, I didn't know what to say. I mean, I didn't know to say yes or
and
no.
You should have been yes, I am that girl.
I felt awkward, like, wo ladki Karan ke paas jaake aise aise kya. So I didn't know what to say. I was like, is this a good thing? I was just like, but then yeah, post that, when I got D3, lot of things changed for me. Like, I started getting many followers, and then the first thing that happened to me was the mob. Okay, like, obviously I've never experienced that. I was just 18, and obviously when I used to travel, like, maybe I had to go to town or somewhere, so obviously the only mode of the mode of transport was train, right? And suddenly I realized people started recognizing me. But once I was sitting in a train and I was really sleepy, okay? So I just passed out, kind of, you know, I was just like that. And I was sleeping, okay? I was coming back from my college. I was sleeping. And then I woke up, and then I see this girl. She's staring at me, okay? Like that. She's staring at me. And I freaked out. I woke up and I freaked out. I'm like, what? And she's like, आपको मैंने कहीं देखा है, आपको मैंने देखा है, D3 से हो ना, आप, and I was like, oh my God, I was so scared. The train was on in motion, and there was no, and I was far, far away from my station, so I couldn't even get down. So I didn't say anything. I was just like, नहीं नहीं वो मैं नहीं हूँ. I told her, no, नहीं मैं नहीं हूँ, वो कोई और.
Okay, this brings us to the first game of our show. ये गेम तो कोई भी एक्सपेक्ट नहीं करता है, स्पेशली इन टॉक शो. इट्स लाइक द मोस्ट अनएक्सपेक्टेड गेम एवर इन अ टॉक शो.
नाउ आई एम स्कैर्ड, नाउ सिंस यू सेड दैट.
या द गेम्स नेम इज नेवर हैव आई एवर.
ओह माय गॉड, आई हेट दिस गेम.
So, okay. The game rules are that if you have to say you have, then you kind of like give yourself like a self high five, like that.
Like that. However, okay. Okay. If you haven't,
then you give like a like this with the sound. Okay. Okay. I might have follow up questions, but let's see how the game goes. All right.
Okay.
First okay. one. Never have I ever dated the same person twice.
No.
You have to think so much. All right. Next one. Never have I ever dated a co-actor.
Can't hide it from the world.
can you hide the name though? Are you going to hide the name or are we?
Yes, 100%. Yes. Please.
Fine. Itna
to banta hai.
Okay, fine. All right, next one.
Yeah.
Never have I ever pretended to not know someone to avoid having a conversation.
I've done that. I think all of us have done
like,
it.
Like, who hasn't?
Oh my God.
If you I haven't, swear, then you're like a, you're like a saint person.
You are too sweet. That means then you are too sweet. I am a very sweet person, by the way.
I know, I know. All right.
Yeah,
never have I ever, never have I ever lied to my parents about being hungover.
Oh my God. So many times. I mean, who hasn't? Who hasn't? Like,
yeah,
everyone's done it, dude. Like,
yeah.
Oh God.
I'm sorry. I'm just.
So, and then I think for some reason, no, like when that happens, when we come back home, it's like we were like that, right? Just before entering, and we enter, we are suddenly like this.
Yeah, and right.
It happens with me. I'm just like, yeah, we had a lot of fun. You know, this girl was there, that guy was there. I just randomly start sharing stuff. And then the other person feels like, oh, yeah, she's fine. I'm like, you know what? I'm really hungry. I'm going to eat something and I'm going to go to sleep. And the other person is like, oh, yeah, okay. I mean, because then there's no doubt, you know, they're like, oh, she's active and she's talking so much. So I'm like, oh, God, bal bache.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, same. You just, out of nowhere, you just come back to your senses and you're like, Satan.
Yeah.
All right, next one. Never have I ever flunked an exam.
No, I don't think so. I was a very good student.
Fine, Anu, fine. We're going straight to the next one.
Hello. Yeah.
All right. Okay. Never have I ever picked my nose in public.
I won't lie. I mean, you know, so I'll tell you what it is. It's not like those disgusting ones where you, you know, pick your nose like
you're
that.
You're just dialing a number, like
But then, no. Ew, not that. I can never do that in public. So, what happens when I have cold or something, right? And, you know, my way of doing it is like that. So, it just moves away, you know? I hate that feeling.
Sometimes it just pops right out, like when you try to do that. Yeah.
Because when I see others, it looks so bad. I mean, I don't even know how to tell them. So when that happens to me, I'm like, oh my God, I know I must be looking like shit. I just need like to do something like that.
I feel your pain. Yeah. All right. This is the last one.
Okay.
Never have I ever lied in this game on my show.
I haven't lied. No.
If you're high-fiving, then you are saying, yes, you've done it. But
I've lied. No.
Sorry. Okay, Anu. Yeah, this brings us to the end of this game. Congratulations with all your amazing answers. I'm proud of you for giving the honest answers that you had for the question.
Yes. Will I be getting any gift hampers?
Yes, you will get all my love. That's all I can offer.
God, can't wait.
Yeah.
Oh,
people
God.
Must be thinking, kya gareeb hai hogi yaar ye, matlab. Hoping for some sponsors to come on board and help me with some amazing gifts for my guests. Sponsors.
It will happen soon.
Yeah.
Soon.
You're doing so much as a dancer, like you're choreographing, you are performing, you are teaching, you're judging. So much is happening. And like, I don't think a lot of people know this about you, but you were also one of the assistant choreographers for Bosco and Cesar. How is that experience, like being in the Indian film industry and, you know, go and choreograph such big numbers, like such hit numbers.
Oh my God.
How does that
that's a whole different ball game altogether, you know, like that also happened to me, I think 2 years back. It just happened, like I got a call from my friend that, you know, Anu, there's a song you have to choreograph. and I want your style. And that time, you know, whacking was not really there on Indian cinema or Indian songs, yeah. Bollywood songs. It was not much used. So they called me and I went and I choreographed a number. And then I had to teach it to the artist. And the artist was my first song ever. The artist was Scarlett Wilson. Yeah. So she's an amazing dancer. Killed the routine. Killed the dance number. But unfortunately, it was it couldn't be released as a movie in theaters, but it was released as a series in Eros Now. Yeah, so the song is there. People don't know about it, but I thought I'll share it, and I'll share it soon, actually.
Awesome.
So that was my first song. And the shoot was in London, and the experience was crazy because I didn't know. Yeah, and it was crazy because I didn't know. That was my first time as an assistant choreographer. So I'm always used to being on screen, right? Like then slowly, you know, I started learning everything that happens behind the screen. And I just absolutely fell in love with the environment, with the field that I started working in. Then it's been like, right now it's been three years.
Wow.
So now it's been 3 years that I'm working. Yeah, working as an assistant choreographer. And it's just been amazing. And the highlight of the whole journey is when I got to teach Madhuri Dixit.
Oh, so, man. I still know that.
She is everything to me. Like, I was so nervous when I went to her house to show her what I grabbed and I made her whack. I mean, I just can't believe it. I still can't believe that this happened. So right now I'm in a position where, you know, initially you're like a little starstruck with these actors when you work with such big artists that, oh my God, like, Ranbir Kapoor or wow, Akshay Kumar or, you know, that happens. And, I mean, when people, like, for example, Ranbir Kapoor, have to tell him, sir, the step is this or that. It's not that. So if I get out, you know, my fanness in me, then I'll just be like, like, you know, staring at him or something.
Like,
but
you do whatever. I love you.
Job.
Yeah.
Yeah, just like you know, if so, he was like, we did an ad shoot, and he was like, ma'am, yeah, step it. He was not getting it. Thoda practice kar, he was like, and he was struggling. Then I was like, ma'am, kya step it? And I was just like, what? For one second, I just lost it. And I'm like, no, Anu, this is your work, your job. We have to do your job. And then I'm like, sir, aisa hai. And then I'm like, this right and left. And then I'm teaching him. He's like, yeah, aisa. I'm like, yeah, correct.
Yeah.
Yes, sir, correct. And then I turn back and I'm just like, oh, God, that is difficult. So this happens with me. This happens with me when I work with such good-looking artists. And, you know, like, yeah, but then
of course.
I don't get starstruck and all, apart from a few actors like Madhuri and Shah Rukh sir and, you know, these guys.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow. Anu,
you remember the Shah Rukh moment?
I did. And I was envying you all like so much. I was like, why am I not there? You know, I was like, fine. Okay, mera apna time aayega. Sorry.
Apna time aayega.
This brings us to the second game of the show, which is known as...
Second game, okay.
Yes, which is known as Speak About This for a Minute.
It'll take me back to my school life. My God.
So I have a bowl full of chits here. Okay. What you have to do is you have to pick a number from 1 to 8 and that will be your topic. And you have to speak about that topic for a minute. Okay.
Okay. Okay. Okay.
Go ahead. Pick a number.
Number one.
Number one it is. Okay. I have a feeling this one's going to be epic.
What is it? Oh my God, you're laughing. You're laughing.
It's Booger.
What is it?
It's Booger.
Oh my God.
It's exactly what we were talking about a while ago. Booger it is.
Oh my God.
Okay, your time starts now. Go.
Okay, so Google is something that obviously, of course, everyone knows what exactly it is. It's something that comes out of our nose and just stays there. And, you know, sometimes it's very irritating, especially like I discussed in the show earlier, you know, when it comes out and it just stays there and you feel very uncomfortable. Because when I see others, you know, it's just there, it irritates me. And I feel like telling them that, you know, I think you should do something something about it, but then I can't. So when that happens to me, I feel damn nervous and irritated. So, you know, I sometimes just, you know, do something to move it from there, you know, from that place, because it feels damn annoying when it's just there, you know. And then, you know, I still don't understand why people eat it. Like, I have seen people do that, you know, they pick their nose and then they take it out and they eat it. I mean,
five, I don't know if it's... Four, three...
protein or what?
Man, your time is up. Oh my god, wow.
I think so bad.
I think it's the grossest, I don't know if grossest
thing
is the
to
word,
talk about. But, yeah. For sure, people will look at me, Huma ma'am, ye kya bol rahi thi? Mujhe to kuch samajh hi nahi aaya kya.
I'll get DMs now.
I'll get DMs and people will unfollow me. They're like, Huma ma'am is mad. She's talking about Bogar in public.
This brings us to the end of this episode, Anshuma. Thank you so much for coming on my show. I had a blast and we had a lot of gossip and chatting that we did today. So yeah, it was
fun. Out there in public. Now people know about everything.
Please go follow Anshuma on Instagram. She posts amazing dance videos. She posts amazing pictures that her mother clicks for her. And she posts a lot of content that you will totally love. So go for it and follow her right now.
So guys, yeah, follow both of us, please. And enjoy. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode and give lots of love to this amazing girl right here. And thanks for calling me again.
If you like this video, make sure to like, share and subscribe to my channel. And if you have anything to say to us, drop it down right now. Thank you for watching the 6th episode of Dimples Out starring Ayushi. I'm your host, signing off. I will see you next Saturday with the 7th episode of the show. Thank you and bye-bye.